Dennis, let's look at Kamaldeen signing for Star Union. Are you surprised? For me, I'm surprised.
Yeah, I think it's a surprise to, I mean, a lot of the footballing world, but there was something that had been, I mean, it was being cooked in the background for, I mean, for the past 3 weeks or so, almost a month ago, it had been coming ever since. So let me start right from, I mean, where it all started. Kamaldeen, he, as you mentioned, from the Nordjylland team, I mean, from right to Dream Academy straight to Nordjylland, and this season was literally his exploding season. That's when he came into the limelight, especially the latter part of the season, scoring 10 goals and also 7 assists in the season so far. But then he caught the eye of Ajax and they achieved that Marco van Basten. He literally worked on Kamaldeen, I mean,
sure,
for over 6 months, literally just working on him. Even reached the point he had to flee from that's the Netherlands to Denmark just to watch him play. So he was a very, very top target for Ajax. I mean, a prime target for the team. And the deal almost got, I mean, closed and also almost got finished.
But sure,
then, the player had, I mean, some concerns, especially about the Ajax team. You can see that with the Ajax, we have, I mean, lots of, should I say, attacking exploits.
Okay.
You know, they had Oussama Idrissi. He was brought in, a very young Moroccan winger. He failed to struggle to live up to the billing in the Ajax team, and also they had Quincy Promise, who had left out of the team to join, that is, Spartak Moscow. So they, this means the Ajax needed to bring in new attackers to fill in this spot. But already they had a very couple few. They had their captain Dusan Tadic, who plays as the left winger in the team. They also did have that is David Neres in the team. Also had Sebastian Haller in the team, and then also Anthony, the Brazilian, also the young Brazilian, also in the team. So these are attacking experts in the team, and Kudus plays, I mean, he can play any of the attacking lines, right from left winger as a striker or the right winger, but then he mostly prefers to play as the left winger, and that means that his main competition was going to be the captain of the team, Dusan Tadic. I mean, if let's say you're going to Accra to folk and you're left back, and you know you're going to play against Radio Vuka, it's very, and you're a young prospect, it's very difficult for you to accept such, I mean, a task. So it was quite a bit difficult for him, especially looking at the other options which were coming up. And Rene are literally building a young powerhouse in Europe, because you look through their team already. They have Jeremy Doku, the young Jeremy Doku. We saw his exploits in the Euro 2020. I mean, very wonderful winger. They also do have, that is, Eduardo Camavinga. We've seen his exploits in midfield. I mean, pecking the interest of the likes of Manchester United, Roma, with a host of European clubs. They've also brought in, that is, like, but he is a very highly rated centre back in Europe. They've brought him into their team, I mean, this transfer window, which was a very, very big gain for them. They are also looking to bring in that is Jean Kajas. He's also a very highly rated another midfielder in Europe, looking to bring him into their team also. So they are building a very, very powerful team of youngsters. They also last season brought in Steven Theria, and also another very powerful winger in the Rene team. So for Kamaldeen, he visited the Rene team. He went through the structures of the team, everything that the team has to offer. He was shown the prospect of Rene, and it looks very exciting in his eye to play with, I mean, a lot of players who are of his age bracket, very young, very talented, and I mean, they have prospect to be the best.
Sure.
It looks so exciting on the target. And also looking through as, I mean, the things at the Rene Football Academy
Club,
it looked exciting for him, especially considering what he'll be facing at Ajax. Don't forget that Kudus Mohamed went to Ajax from Nordjylland last season, and then after getting injured in the first part of the season, he kind of struggled before the latter part of the season. He started picking up his feet. So For the Ajax team, it's very difficult for you to progress, despite it being, I mean, one of the teams we know them to promote.
Sure.
It's very, very difficult for you to progress, especially considering that your main target you'll be competing with is a captain of Ajax, that is Dusan Tadic, especially as a young prospect. I mean, he wants to progress very quickly and very now. And I mean, Leo looked much more exciting for him. So, I mean, for Rene, I mean, it's a very good buy for them, as you mentioned. Very, very exciting young player. I mean, with the ball at his feet, very few players
can
go and move as fast as he can. I'm very excited to see a Ghanaian, I mean, play this match.
Sure.
It's exciting for the years coming ahead.
But we hope Rene is a place that he can develop his talent very, very
well. Yes, I mean, that's the hope of every guy.
Sure.